The biggest mistake a software developer can do in projects is not to keep backup. And as a result, if some accident or a crash in the system occurs, all the work done is lost in just a second. So the question is, how to keep backup and how to avoid these troubles? One very simple way to do so is to make a backup of your project files in a separate folder and zip it and upload it on storage cloud. However, doing so raises another problem. Whenever you save your project, you will have to repeat this process again and again. And if for some reason you forgot to do that, it can mess up. Second method is to use version control system. The mostly used version control system is named as Git. Thankfully, with the Git and GitHub system, the process of making backup is made easy by just simple commands and graphic user interface buttons. In solo development, you can simply get back your earlier work done by getting the last code you committed to Git. In teamwork, it is also very handy. However, some rules need to be taken care of. Suppose there are three members in your team. You commit your project on Git first time and all three of your team members are working on the same Git. It can cause the same problem as was seen in the file system. Git provided some cool solutions to it by introducing merge. Merge gives you an opportunity to decide on your own as to what code you need and what code you don't need. In a team, you can delete work of other team members by mistake, as you may not know what is done by whom. A solution to that is the project is controlled by team lead, and whenever it's merge time, a request to merge is generated, and team lead will decide whether to merge it or not. But if by mistake, team lead deletes something during merge, it can cause issue. Also, repeating it again and again may not be feasible. But then Git provides another solution by introducing branches. Each branch is assigned to one developer and no branch is disturbed by other team members' work at all. Suppose one developer in your team finished his work and he commits his code to the system. That code can be used by other developers by taking a clone or taking a pull to their own branch. But that can lead to a disastrous situation where your own work can mess up. In this case, all you need to do is create another branch locally, so that when the updated code by another developer is pulled on your system, your work is not disturbed. And then later on, you can adjust your local main branch with your own work. And at the time of the merge, you know what needs to be updated. So by using Git, your workflow will get a lot better. And that is the goal. That's all for today. Thank you so much.